Good morning, afternoon, whatever it may be, wherever you are. It is Sunday. It is, what, the 21st of August, right? So this video here, I'm going back to movies. You know, I like movies. I like, you know, it was a big part of my childhood, movies. It's still kind of important to me today, but I don't know. I was just looking back for whatever reason, because as decades pass, you see, you know, you're like, wow, that movie came out that long ago? And so what I'm going to do, I'm going back to 2002, which would be 20 years ago. For some reason, the decade's a big one. The double decade's a big one. Then, of course, you know, we got, you know, the silver, the 25 years, and then the 30, and then the... Then it kind of jumps to 40, then 50 years. That's a big one. In anniversary measures, whether it's, I don't know, I guess whether it's movies or albums or, I don't know, personal relationships. Those are the kind of big things, you know, those are the big ones. I'm just having a little beverage here. This is my Mexican mineral water and pomegranate juice. It's really good. I dilute the pomegranate juice into the mineral water. It's a little tart. It's a little tart. But anyway, so I'm going to go down each month. If I have the movie, I'll show you the DVD. If I don't, well, I don't. But anyway, so January 2022. This movie came out. Orange County. Tom Hanks' son, Colin Hanks. And I do believe this might have been Jack Black's one of his first movies? I think it was. Anyway, this is just, you know, a typical coming-of-age saga. John Lithgow is in it. Who else is in here? I don't know. Colin Hanks, John Lithgow. An MTV Films production. Paramount Pictures. Interesting. There you go. Orange County. Then in February, I have the movie, don't know where it is, John Q. That's a Denzel Washington movie where, now, obviously there's a whole slew of other movies that came out this month, but these are the standouts. Sometimes you just gotta put these things out there. John Q, that's the one where he takes over a hospital because he can't get what he needs done. I think for his child, yeah. Kind of relate to that, no? Okay, then March of 2002, we had Ice Age. That started quite a good franchise there. And we had Blade 2. I have Ice Age, just don't know where it is. Blade 2, actually directed by Guillermo del Toro. As you know from like Pan's Labyrinth and such, and Hellboy. This is good, man. He said one of the first superhero movies right here, Blade. Good stuff, man. Good stuff. Okay, April. Not much going on there. We did have my big fat Greek wedding, which, you know what, I've never saw it. But it was a cultural phenomenon at the time. I remember a lot of people talking about it. I think it won a lot of awards. It was a big hoot-de-doo at the time. Whatever. Not for me, but I am making note of it. Okay. April. Oh, that was April. Okay, May. Oh, May. May. Spider-Man. Sam Raimi. And who's your watch? Wow, John Dykstra did the special effects of this. That's the guy who did 2001 and Silent Running. Interesting. That's why it looks so superior. Huh. Sam Raimi and Tobey Maguire, Willem Dafoe, Kirsten Dunst. This is the greatest trilogy that Marvel ever put out with these three movies right here. And this might very well be one of the greatest. I did not know John Dykstra did a special effect for that. Until right now. What else came out there? Star Wars Episode II, Attack of the Clones. I don't know, the one everyone hates. I don't know. They hate the whole trilogy. I liked the trilogy. I always liked it. I was never, liked it. It was different from the original ones. It was a little more cerebral. But Attack of the Clones, I like it. Anyway, so we had Attack of the Clones. I had the regular disc somewhere, but I'm just showing you that. And then we had this. Insomnia by Christopher Nolan. This is when Christopher Nolan started. This is his first movie. This is one of his first movies. It's in Alaska, and it's an LAPD detective is. It's a psychological thriller. Okay. So, whatever. It's got Al Pacino, Robin Williams, and Hilary Swank. All outstanding performances. For Christopher Nolan, baby. Okay, what else we got next? Alright. And then in June was a good month. We had the start of this friend. Why is it getting dark? The Bourne Identity. Need I say more? The Bourne movies are fantastic, especially this trilogy. And I also like the one with Jeremy Renner, The Bourne Legacy. The Jason Bourne movie that came out a few years ago, trash. Not for me. What else came out in June of 2020? Minority Report. What? It's a great movie. A lot of predictive programming in this, people. This is Tom Cruise and Steven Spielberg. Okay, then what do we have? We had Scooby-Doo. That came out, too, that year. I got it. Just don't know where it is. We have this. We got Mr. Deeds. Adam Sandler. Adam Sandler was cranking them out. This, I think, is a very funny movie. I liked it. I like Adam Sandler. I like his comedies. I think it's funny. But anyway, this is a funny movie to me. Then we had Men in Black 2. Men in Black 2 came out. We also had this little thing with Christian Bale and Matthew McConaughey, Reign of Fire. It's a good movie. I like this movie a lot. I watch this again. It's a good movie. We had the last one of the Austin Powers collection. Goldmember. Then we had Road to Perdition. That's that movie with Tom Hanks and Paul Newman. Kind of a gangster movie. That's a good movie, man. Takes place in the 30s, I think. I think it's the 30s, maybe 20s, 30s. Daniel Craig's in that, too. That's some good stuff. Okay, the one we got, August. August, we got Signs. M. Night Shyamalan Signs. I think this is the one he put out. This is the one he put out after the one with Bruce Willis. Who is that? I don't know. I forget the name. But this is good. It's got Joaquin Phoenix, Mel Gibson. This is good. This is some good stuff, man. Great. Run, children. Anyway. And then also it's a Triple X with Vin Diesel. I got that, too. Just don't know where it is. But anyway, September and Resident Evil. Let's start it this off. Here's the first movie in Resident Evil. Mila Jovovich and Michelle Rodriguez. I don't know. They're not very cerebral movies. They're just a fun watch. You kind of got to suspend belief. It's just, I don't know. It's a ridiculous franchise. You put it on. There you go. Entertainment. Then, October of 2002, we had this. The Transporter. This is good. Jason Statham. These three movies are fantastic. They're just great. They're off the hook. They're over the top. Kind of almost like the Jason Bourne movies. And Taken and that lone whack job everybody's hunting down. Can't stop them. Whatever. Transporter. Then we had this, Red Dragon, sequel to The Silence of the Lambs. Wow, this is this has got some cuckoo shit in it. This is a good cast in this. Ed Norton, Ralph Fiennes. Good follow-up. Good sequel. That was in October. And then we also had The Ring. The Ring. That was the remake of the horror movie from Japan, which was a worthy remake as far as an American adaptation. I thought it was good. I liked it. Anyway, November. What did we have in November? We had Die Another Day. James Bond. The last James Bond. I think it was the last James Bond outing by Pierce Brosnan. Halle Berry's in this too. James Bond. Then we had the second Harry Potter movie, Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. That was good. What else we had? We had Eminem's 8 Mile. That was a good movie. I saw it. Good movie. Then we had Friday After Next. This is the final trilogy in that. Hilarious. These movies are funny, man. Funny. Friday, next Friday, and Friday After Next. These are just comedy gold. They're just very funny movie. Okay, so now we move along to the last month, December. We had Catch Me If You Can that came out on Christmas Day, which I have, I just don't have it here. That's that Tom Hanks and what's his name? Leonardo DiCaprio. There was like dueling Leonardo DiCaprio movies. Amazing. The week before, they put out this Martin Scorsese, Gangs in New York. This is a fantastic movie. Just a fantastic, fantastic beer. Daniel Day-Lewis. Everybody's great in this. Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers. Need I say more? What else? Confessions of a Dangerous Mind. That was a George Clooney movie about, what's his name? Harris. Barris? Barris, the guy from The Gong Show. Boy, did he lead a double life. He was part of the CIA, assassin. Just a crazy movie. You could take it for what it is. I thought it was fantastic. And then we have this with Christian Bale, Taye Diggs, Emily Watson, Equilibrium. Fantastic movie. So look at that. That's like not all the movies. These are all movies of note that came out in 2002. 20 years ago. Like, what's come out this year that I've seen? This is just like 50 movies. I don't know how many. What is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. It's like 30 movies right here. But what's come out? We've had the multiverse with Marvel Universe thing there. You know, what's this? Doctor Strange. I saw it. I enjoyed it. Then had Thor, Love and Thunder. Didn't see it. Don't care. I'm just completely done with that. I just wanted to see the visuals and Doctor Strange movie. What else came out? Top Gun. That was good. That was good. Not a new movie. Nothing new. What else came out? Morbius. Another, okay. You know, I saw that in the movies. The Northman I saw. That was kind of fun. That was a good movie. That was an original movie. What else was original? There's a couple other originals I didn't see. What else came out? Wow. Everything is like streaming. What else came out? What did they see? I saw that Nick Cage movie. You know, where he plays himself. That was a fun movie. I enjoyed that. I don't know. What else did I see? We used to go to the movies a lot. Even a couple of years ago, we'd go to the movies like, I don't know, at least 2 or 3 times a month. Now, I don't know, 2 or 3 times a month, maybe. Once every 2 or 3 months. Sad. Sad with it. What they destroyed that, dude. Plus, there's no new properties. There's no new ideas. These are all, like all of these. Ice Age, Blade, My Big Fat Greek Wedding, Star Trek, Insomnia, Born Identity, Minority Report, Signs, Transporter, 8 Mile. These are all original movies. There's some sequels in here, obviously, but that's all you get now. Sequels, comic books, meh. Anyway, everyone have a wonderful day. This is my little thing about 20 years ago, movies of 2002. Peace!